This vision was more vivid and intense than what I experienced on my last case. This villain has killed before. They will not stop. They enjoy the pattern and they enjoy the game. I felt what the latest victim felt. I saw what he saw. A pursuit that started in the present, ended in the past, at a place that resembled the dead end where Andrew Chapman died last night. I need to enter the home and have a look around before I investigate the neighborhood. Show yourself! Thank you. This brick is hand-painted. I need to collect all I can find and see how they relate to Chapman's murder.
Thank you.
Chapman was a widower. His ring is missing. It isn't in the box, and it wasn't on the body. This program was paused after the killing and after the forensics team went over the home and crime scene. And channel 187 was no accident. That's the police call number for homicide. Thank you. the dishwasher was meant to get my attention. It's locked and running the killer's cycle to remove evidence. The hunt is being made into a personal game. A weaver's loom. The killer enjoys the chase and has made it personal. The killer is arrogant. Evidence was put on display and set to be washed clean while I investigated. There is nothing to trace on Chapman's shoe. The killer ate a leisurely meal using the place setting, but the antique plate is all wrong. It looks turn of the century and does not fit with any of Andy Chapman's belongings. The killer is playing games. A black light was put in the streetlight. The lab team has no idea about the invisible ink. The outline of the body was made by the killer in the invisible ink. The killer covets where the victim died and may have specifically positioned the body. The arms are in the 8 o'clock position. Today is the 8th. Maybe the number is important, maybe not. This woman has wounds nearly identical to those found on Andrew Chapman's body, but her shredded clothes are from 100 years ago. The bodies fell or were positioned the same way. No signs of a struggle. The killer either surprised him or was never perceived as a threat. The impression on her finger indicates that she wore a ring. It's missing, but her purse is here. Who was that poor woman? I saw her last moments and felt what she did. The end was sudden. She did not see the killer. Her scream was silenced by a male's left hand covered in a leather glove. The killer said nothing, but his mouth was open. His breath came slightly down on her. Judging by her height, the killer could not have been tall. I'm going to explore the neighborhood and learn this woman's name. I can learn more about the victim if I track where she began her walk. Which tracks do I follow? I can learn more about the victim if I track. I can learn more about the victim if I track where she began her walk. Which tracks do I follow? I can learn more. I can learn more about the victim. I can learn more about the victim if I. I can learn more about the victim. I can learn more about the victim if I track where she began her walk. Which... I can learn more about the victim if I track where she began her... I can learn more about the victim if I track where she began her walk. Which tracks do I... Thank you. I can learn more about the victim. I can learn more about the victim. I can learn more. I can learn more about the victim if I track. I can learn more about the victim if I track. It fits, and a bootmaker would have interest in the victim's missing footwear. Knock, knock. If I find solid proof that John Pizer is the killer, he won't get far. Thank you. This is the victim's missing boot. It proves Pizer was at the crime scene and did not inform the police. But was he the killer? I found plenty of shoes, but no traces of blood. I sensed she smelled the leather of the glove that covered her mouth, but not a heavier scent like the hide used in soles or boot polish. Mr. Pizer may have been trying to steal a pair of shoes to sell in his shop, but had to flee before he could finish for fear of being linked to the murder. Pizer definitely made a path to the victim. He saw her, but did he kill her? There's no doubt about it. The victim connects with this building. She might live here.
Thank you.
The killer is playing cat and mouse with a person of authority in this time period. Is the murderer of Andrew Chapman a present-day copycat? I hear deliberate noises. I am not alone. Her ring was not on her body, and it isn't here. Just like Andrew Chapman. A patient wolf. Good with sharp tools left this here, or gave it as a gift. Wonder what ailed her, and where she got this brand of Hocus Pocus snake oil. Someone else was here. That isn't her bite mark. Since when does a woman have mustache hairs?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Her name was Annie Chapman.
Thank you.
Same height grabbed this woman just like Annie Chapman. She felt the hairs of a mustache on her neck. I believe the same predator murdered both women. That mark on the throat. Her locket is missing and she wants it back. Maybe it will lead to her identity. I'm curious about these overcoats, but I can't just rifle through them all. Evidence will give me probable cause to search the right one. Victims of a serial killer. I see Martha Tabram and the unnamed victim. Annie Chapman is marked as the next victim. When I find the missing name, I bet the pattern is the same in Chicago. Someone who works here would be a great suspect. They know the area, make the kill, and admire their handiwork at their leisure when the body is brought in for examination. Mustache hair on the food. Not charming, but interesting if it came from someone the killer's height. I'm curious about the... I'm curious about these overcoats. I'm curious. The locket portrait is school headmaster Montague John Druitt. Perhaps the women were secret rivals and public friends. Annie picked up the killer's coins before the authorities could discover them. And she removed Druitt's picture from the locket because she believed he could have been the killer.
Where are you going, and who do you want to see at the devil's time of night? Where are you going, and who do you want to see at the devil's time of night? Where are you going? You've come to see the boss? Down the hall. If I were you, I'd keep my nose out of other folks' affairs.
Boss? Someone called boss interests me, and so does the person who said it. Tabram? Amarty Tabram died of stab wounds in Cicero on April 7th. The case wasn't connected to Andrew Chapman's because one was female, the other male. Coincidence? Two victims from the 19th century died on the same days as two victims in the present with the same last names. The name of the victim by the fence may confirm my suspicions. The mortuary assistant, Robert Mann, is the same man I met in the school foyer. I see possibilities that would bring a mortuary assistant together with a headmaster interested in anatomy. Said the spider to the fly. London with the East End neighborhood detailed out. Druitt knows his way around. A gift not given, or was it returned? This is expensive. Druitt has money. The doctor has committed his mother for depression and paranoid delusions. Druitt keeps this note near him. Does the diagnosis run in the family? The JP mark on these shoes tells me the Druid was a customer of bootmaker John Pizer. I wonder where these shoes have been. Interesting character, John Druitt. Even in his chosen portrait, he looks depressed. Judging by his classroom, he has a background in anatomy, and there's no disguising that mustache. Interesting character. John Pizer is interesting me again as a suspect. If he had shine stations around the city, he knew the area and its people very well. This one was in proximity to the first victim. I'm curious about. Interesting character.
Thank you.
Of course. The desks are arranged like September 1888, and 2 days have importance, the 8th and the 30th. And on September 8th, 1888, Annie Chapman was the victim. And on September 30th, the killer promises to strike again.
Thank you.
The charcoal gray thread is woolen, and that discoloration is unmistakably blood. Were the slide and thread mistakes by the killer, or convenient plants? I'm going to follow the evidence and look for a charcoal gray wool coat. Mr. Robert Mann, mortuary assistant, wearing a woolen, charcoal gray coat fashion statement. Good to see you again this evening, Mr. Mann. Thank you for your assistance in directing me to Headmaster Druitt. Robert Mann became the strongest suspect, but is he a careless killer or a guy being set up? If the blood on his coat belongs to the victim, it could be murder or just an accident of his occupation. The victim who died on August 31st is Polly Nichols. Her murder came before Annie Chapman and after Martha Tabram. Tabram and Andrew Chapman fit a serial killer's last name pattern, not Weaver. This accident wasn't meant to kill me. I have to find someone named Nichols who died on September 8th. This .40 caliber is standard issue to the Chicago Police Force. I've found the car of missing undercover officer Paul Nichols. He was missing on the same day that Polly Nichols was murdered. I fear the present-day Nichols met with a similar fate. I need to find him. I don't like being in the spotlight. Something has to be done about that camera.
Runway 4 Crossroads.
This will be at Odell Middle School, 14401, Northeast 8. 8 to 10 males on school grounds refusing to leave. They're now located between the pool house parking lot.
12-1-9-3-3-10. Yeah, you're really doing a lot of stuff down here for the afternoon. I'm doing all of this to really.
Look it down.
Kelly has detailed knowledge of the infamous East End slasher. The list of suspects compiled by historians includes a man named James Kelly. Is Jimmy Kelly the copycat killer? Or is he just a man who stumbled upon a curious fact from the past? I'm going to get an ebook copy and learn more. Kelly has detailed knowledge of the infamous... Is Jimmy Kelly the copycat killer? Or is he just... These patterns may be significant. Can't rely on memory. These patterns may be significant. Can't rely on memory. Recognize these symbols. They're not gang signs. I need someone else to take a look. I don't recognize these symbols. The card is deliberately filled. Murder days and ages of the victims. The evidence is telling me that Paul Nichols is dead. Security cameras would show the killer if Paul Nichols was murdered on August 31st. Nichols. Heads you live, tails you die. Paul Nichols is dead. 8:30 sharp. No one on this case dies that early in the evening. Chapman died on the 8th. The killer plans to use their sharp blade again on September 8th and 30th. The killer has the knowledge to manipulate security systems. Kelly is an obvious suspect. I need a picture of this. Samantha, any idea what these symbols are and what they mean? Best, Angelica.
On your end, so I'll take a leap of faith that you're receiving this message. The symbols are ancient Sumerian. The two on the left are the numbers 7 and 31. The third symbol is rare, something like blood rejuvenation. I can't be sure about the two that are scratched out.
A copycat killer that dabbles in ancient Sumerian text? This implies someone highly educated in a specialized, almost obsessive academic subject. If the killer has the same skills as a suspect in the past, I would rule out bootmaker John Pizer. Headmaster Druitt looks more suspicious, but Robert Mann had access to his library. this is the car I want.